guys. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. Well, today we had our first X-Flare for the year. Today is January 6, 2023. Sunspot region AR3182 blasted out an X-Flare, the strongest category of a flare. The last time the sun blew out an X-Flare was back on October 2nd of last year, 2022. This sunspot region is just now coming around the solar disk. It's going to go from left to right. Here we have AR3182. We got AR31 and AR3183, and up above it is AR3180. But this is the bad boy right here. All right, for today it looks like we got several C flares. Let's see, we got a C1.59, a C2, that one's 6.9. There's been several of them all squished together. C215, did I do that one? C188. Here is the X flare. It was right next to it's an M flare. M.88. Okay. X122. And then afterwards we have a C281, a C124. Yeah, there's lots of them through here. A lot of C flares. C622. A C5.07. And more recently it looks like we got a M163. So it was at 23 minutes after midnight universal time. And they're calling this X flare a non-eruptive flare, which means no coronal mass ejection was observed. Two important things they find is going on with this sunspot area. One, it is an area that is just now rotating into view. And second, it is now showing a gamma configuration, the most complex and potentially active configuration, a complex region in which the positive and negative polarities are so irregularly distributed that they can't be classified as a bipolar sunspot group. In the last 24 hours, this region of the sun has had 13 C flares and one M-class flare, and them at NASA are saying to expect strong activity coming from this region. If you look at it, let me pull it over. It almost looks like was it the Lord of the Rings, that one little creature that kept stealing the ring, calling it my precious, you know, which maybe many of you probably know what I'm talking about, but doesn't that not look like that creature from the Lord of the Rings? They're saying for the next 24 hours, you can expect a 95% chance for more C flares, and a 30% chance for M flares, and a 5% chance for more X flares. So many are probably wondering, what's the difference between an eruptive and a non-eruptive event? One that sends out a CME and one that doesn't. Well, evidently it's got a lot to do with temperature. Systematic differences in the relationship between peak temperature and intensity for the two types of events are also evident, with flares accompanied by a coronal mass ejection CME tending to have lower peak temperature than non-ejective events of the same intensity. The change in behavior of the flares from one day to the next, from eruptive to confined, where it doesn't send out any coronal mass ejection, can be attributed to the change in orientation of the magnetic field below the fan with respect to the orientation of the overlying spine, rather than the overall changes in the stability of the large scale field. These type of non-eruptive flares have only been known for about 30 years. They have been seen in other flares, M flares, and I'm not sure about C flares, but they have been seen in M-class flares also. But there is speculation and discussions among the scientists that these types of flares make the area very unstable, where it could cause the effect of more flares to come. Yeah, hopefully they're not larger. But be prepared, because they can cause power outages and interference with your GPS and phones and satellites and television, things like that. Yeah, we got enough problems with our power fluctuating, don't we? So what are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. And as I've been telling you lately, be prepared for any type of disaster. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you.